Welcome everyone to Defender for Cloud in the Field. Before I start, just wanted to say once again, thank you very much for our audience. We had such a great lineup in 2023 and we are already starting 2024 with some great episodes. So make sure to subscribe to the Microsoft Security Channel, in particular to our playlist, which is the AKA link below, and click on the bell to receive notifications when new videos are uploaded. Well, in today's episode, we are going to talk about some very interesting stuff that we release in Defender for Cloud about agentless malware detection. And to talk about this, we have the feature PM that owns this capability in the engineering team, Gao Fengsen. Gao, thank you very much for being on, and sorry for the mistake on your last name.
That's okay. Thanks for having me. I'm really excited.
Yes, we've been talking about this moment of recording this episode for a long time, and so I'm really glad that finally we are doing this.
Definitely.
Now, this feature, I really need you to explain a little bit more about what really is the problem that we are trying to resolve with this new capability, since we already have some other capabilities related to malware as part of Defender for Cloud. So can you give an overview about what it is and what are we trying to solve?
Yes, definitely. This is great questions. Well, you are correct. As for today, we have multiple detection sources in MDC and Defender for Servers particularly. Most of them are based on Microsoft EDR, Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, and its antivirus capability. We also have network detections and control plane detections. But we identified some blind spots on those, both on resources that are covered by these agent-based solutions and on resources that are not covered at all. First, it's coverage. As we know, not all the resources in customers' environment are currently protected by agent-based solution. And in this case, agentless malware scanning can fill the gap and be the first and the only source to detect malicious activity and detect threat that wouldn't have been discovered otherwise. A second potential blind spot can be resides also in resources that are protected with agent-based solution. One example is file exclusions. We know that today, as part of performance tuning, there may be overuse or misuse of files, folders, and sometimes entire directories, exclusion of those from AV scans. Another example can be that the agent-based AV will run without the most updated signatures or will not run in sufficient periods. So in those cases, the agentless malware scanning capability can be sort of an additional protection layer and provide detections, scans the machines, including scan files that are excluded, and scan and continuously perform full and quick scans in places that wouldn't have been scanned otherwise. All of this without performance impact on the machine.
And just to clarify, this capability is part of which plan?
This is a great question. So this is another capability that that utilizes our already existing agentless scanning capability for virtual machines that is already in GA. It's just another scenario that utilizing this capability. And this is going to be available for Defender for Servers Plan 2 only.
All right, so whoever has already Defender for Servers Plan 2 will receive this capability as part of it.
As long as customers have Defender for Servers Plan 2 and agentless scanning enabled, they will be able to get this capability.
Okay, and can you explain a little bit more how the scanning process works?
Yes, definitely. So as I mentioned, this is just another protection layer that utilizes the agentless scanning capability. In short, what we do is taking a snapshot of the VM, This snapshot is being analyzed in isolated, non-shared environment within the same region of the VM, the local region. After the scan is over, the snapshot is being deleted and findings are being sent to the platform. In our case, the malware scanner is scanned the VMs using Microsoft antivirus, Microsoft Defender antivirus engine, including all its capabilities, heuristic and signature-based detections and signatures. Before every scan, we are making sure we are using the most updated protection that is backed up with Microsoft Defender intelligence and research. And another capability is the cloud protection, which making sure that the intelligence and the research is more accurate. So once this malware scanner is over, as I mentioned, the snapshot is being deleted and security alerts are being sent to MDC portal for customers to consume, to process. These alerts contains additional information about the malware that has been detected, the file information, and of course, what customers can do to resolve this issue.
And when do you suggest or when do you recommend to use agentless malware detection?
So the answer is simple, always. You see, the onboarding is seamless. All you have to do is ensure that you have Defender for Servers Plan 2 and agentless scanning is enabled. So I recommend to use it wherever customers can, both on resources that are currently protected by another EDR, and of course on resources that are currently not protected at all. More than that, this capability suggests new improved hybrid approach of utilizing both the agentless malware scanning and the agent-based AV, and take the benefits of both of the solution. As while the agent-based AV provides you deep visibility to the OS, behavioral analysis, real-time protection and response, the agentless capability provides you wider coverage, frictionless onboarding, no agent footprint on your machines, results within hour, and of course, with no performance impact on your machines. So leveraging the advantages of both of the capabilities suggests a lot new opportunities and a wider, broader range of capabilities that may come in the future.
Do we have, because I'm assuming that this, just like many of the agentless capabilities, there is nothing to configure when it comes to the malware detection, right? As soon as it's enabled, it just happens behind the scenes and that's it, correct?
Of course, yes, definitely.
And what is the frequency that this happens?
Yeah, so currently the scanner provide results every 24 hours. And these results are security alerts that indicate whether we found malware on your machines.
All right, so let's take a look on this this alert. Let's go to the demo and take a look on that.
Okay, so now we will see how these alerts are looks like in Defender for Cloud portal. So this is the overview page. I'm going to the security alerts page. And here I can see by the name that these are agentless alerts that part of the malware scanning capability. When I'm clicking on the alerts, as the usual alerts, you can see additional information about the alert, which threat it detected, and also going deeper, you will be able to see additional information about the file path that the malware was detected in, which type of the malware is, and what can you do to further investigate these alerts. As I mentioned before, these alerts will be also available in Microsoft XDR portal as part of Defender for my M365 portal.
Gal, this was great. Love the fact that we are showing the results on the alerts and that this also is going to be available on the M365 portal. And of course, if we have the connector with Sentinel, it's going to be going to Sentinel as well.
Of course.
Any final consideration or recommendation that you want to express or ask our customers to do?
No, as I mentioned, make sure you have Defender for Servers Plan 2 and Agentless enabled. It's all you need to make sure to get the new capability.
All right, I do have one last question because
okay.
I'm not sure if it is clear. Is this capability available for Windows and Linux?
Yes, definitely. For Windows, for Linux, and for multi-cloud servers.
All right, so it doesn't matter if my VM is in Azure, AWS, or GCP. This is going to work.
Yes, definitely.
All right, so excellent. So this is multi-cloud, this is Linux, and this is Windows. So we covered the whole thing. Awesome. Thank you very much, Gal, for your time
today.
Thank
you today. So much, Yuri.
Truly appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
All right, everyone. That's a wrap for today's episode. Thank you very much for your audience. Make sure to subscribe to our playlist, the AKA link below. And see you again next time.